Hello, this is Bern, and if you've been afraid of entering a relationship with a man because you're scared of getting your heart broken, you need to hear what I'm about to share with you today. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life to be.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart open, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams without gimmicks, manipulation, or any crazy techniques, and as a result of stepping into the most feminine, most alive, most conscious version of yourself. Should you risk heartbreak or not? That is the question. So many women reach out to me because they want love, but they're not stepping into love because they don't want to get their heart broken, and I totally get it. It's so painful to get your heart broken, and it's something that if you can avoid it, you should avoid it. However, here's my big theme for the day. If you are going to enter a loving relationship of any kind, but especially one that is of the intimate kind, your heart will break, period. In the most conscious, most kind, most loving relationship, your heart will break. So now that you understand this concept, your heartbreak is unavoidable if you enter a connection with another human being. The question becomes, is all heartbreak the same? And it's not. All heartbreak is not created equal. There's, in my mind, conscious, unavoidable heartbreak, and there is unconscious, avoidable to a high level extent, heartbreak. Let me give you some examples so you understand what I mean. Unavoidable heartbreak. You connect with a man you love, and a family member that he loves is suffering, you will suffer with him. And there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, it's not one of those things where you can just pump him up and say, well, but I mean, he still has 3 months to leave. That's awesome. It's still gonna suck for him and it's still gonna suck for you. That's heartbreak. Or maybe you connect with him and there's areas of life where he and you don't necessarily meet eye to eye. And these are important areas, not important enough to where you're gonna say, well, I'm not gonna be in a relationship with him, but important nonetheless. And the fact that you guys are not as compatible as you thought you could have been will break your heart. Sometimes he will say things that he doesn't mean. Sometimes you'll say things you don't mean, and that will break each other's heart temporarily. That is unavoidable, my dear. You can get better and better, but it's still gonna hurt, it's still gonna suck, and your heart will break. Now, avoidable heartbreak will be you connect with a guy who puts you down all the time. You connect with a guy who's a narcissist and it's all about himself and not about you. You connect with a guy who doesn't listen to you, doesn't see you, doesn't hunger for you, doesn't find you attractive, doesn't find you passionate. That is avoidable heartbreak. It's avoidable because there's no need to be with a human being where you can either A, attempt to make the relationship better, but if it's not getting better, if he doesn't want to change, then it's avoidable. You could just step out of it and enter a new relationship or be with yourself for a while, right? But even that will break your heart, right? Because you'll stop being with him and there's things that you'll miss about him. What else is avoidable heartbreak? Well, choosing the same type of man with a different face and the type of man who is unavailable, right? And the guy, kind of guy who's gonna constantly reject you, constantly ignore you. That is heartbreak, but it's heartbreak of the unconscious, shitty kind. So what I'll share with you regarding heartbreak is, should you risk heartbreak? Absolutely. If you're unwilling to risk heartbreak, you will stay in a mountain meditating alone for the rest of your life. So the first thing you need to do is take some time out. After you've experienced heartbreak, you need to take some time out. Ideally, get an outside perspective, including professional perspective, to get a different sense of what's really going on. You need to identify what the root cause is of the heartbreak. Most times, whether you're aware of it or not, there is a common thread, a common theme among the guys that you've been connecting with, the situations, the pain, and sometimes it's hard to come up with it on your own. So seeking out outside help who's seen this maybe hundreds of times and can say in a few minutes, here's what I feel is going on, will be beneficial. But if nothing else, at least taking some time on your own and saying, here's a common thread of what I've been going through, so that once you understand that, then step B is make a plan of action to prevent it. Because if you can prevent, if you can avoid as much as possible, that type of guy, that type of situation, set stronger boundaries, be more outspoken, when you feel that something's weird, instead of pushing it down, expressing it, all those things will help you to prevent entering a relationship like that. And if you do happen to enter one like that, will help you to snap out of it much sooner. So step B is create a plan of action to mitigate the risks, significantly reduce the chances that you'll end up in the same situation that you've been on multiple times with different faces, right? The next one will be, step C will be the gradual opening of the relationship. So when I say you should risk loving again, if you're gradually opening, gradually connecting, gradually learning more about him, and as he shows up with strength, with clarity, with passion, with commitment, with respect, you open more, then can he still break your heart in an unconscious way? Yes, but the chances are lower. If you go all in, you connect with him one day, second date, you're having sex, third date, you're talking about future, fourth date, he disappears, it's not uncommon. He was over his head, basically. He was promising shit he couldn't deliver, right? And you were falling for it. So gradually open, take longer than you usually take to connect with him, longer than you usually take to have sex with him, longer than you usually take to plan that future together. It doesn't mean you don't talk about what you want, but it just means that for you to actually plan the future with them, you need to really know him. If you take this time to be more conscious about it, you will experience beautiful heartbreak of the kind that allows you to know that it's that you're alive, that life is important, that life is valuable, but you'll avoid more of that unconscious heartbreak that is unnecessary in my mind and is preventing you from experiencing the kind of love that is your birthright and the kind of love that will infuse you with passion, with excitement, and with sustainable joy in your life. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful. If it is, I'm gonna ask you, my dear, yes, you, three things. Number one, click like on this video or thumbs up. Number two, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and click on the little bell if you want to be notified of new episodes as they come out. Step three, most important of all, and there's two parts to step three. Part one, there's a link under the description of this video, the first link that allows you to step into a masterclass that I've created for you that will show you how to step into the kind of relationship you want with a lot less pain than your current trajectory. All you do when you click on that link, enter your name and email, and you'll be redirected to watch this masterclass immediately. If you feel like you want my specific help to identify what's really going on and how to avoid it for good, you want coaching and mentorship to get this, there's another link under the description of this video where you can apply for a conversation with me to see if we're fit to work together. If I feel I can help you after reading your application, my assistant will reach out to you and schedule a time and we'll connect. If I don't feel I can help you, then I won't waste your time by scheduling a call. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.